Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. We get a lot of questions about radon discharges not having rain caps, about rain getting down in the radon system, and is it gonna ruin the system? The answer is no. You do not need to have a cap on the top of the radon system, and it's preferred that you do not. It's all pitched to allow water condensation to drain back to the suction point or suction points that you have. So the radon fans are designed to deal with water. They can handle a little bit of water that runs through them. So here we've got our suction point down here. The pipe, this 3-inch pipe goes up, and this is supposed to be the attic. So it'd be simulating the fan in the attic. We've got an RP145 radon fan from Radonaway here. And then if we turn it this way, this would be simulating the roof. So we got the shingles and then our pipe coming out the top there. So right now I don't have anything on the top. It's just an open 3-inch pipe. So we are gonna plug this in and we are gonna check and see what kind of airflow we get and more importantly, where that air is going when we have an open cap. All right, so I'm set up now. Here's the different types of fittings that we're gonna put on the top of this radon system and see what happens when we use our puffer and see where that smoke goes. So we're gonna start out with this B-vent rain cap. I actually pulled this off a system that we replaced a fan on maybe a year or two ago. We've got a 45, this is all 3-inch again. We've got a T, we got a 90. We got a varmint guard. This is from Radonaway. This is 1/2-inch screen. And then we got a varmint guard with 1/4-inch screen. And then we've got kind of the U shape. So some of these are allowed, some are not allowed, some are allowed with an asterisk. So let's take a look and see what we got. I ran the numbers on this already. So I used my pitot tube measuring the airflow inside the pipe. And then a special thanks to Josh Kerber, who used his handy dandy spreadsheet to give me the exact CFMs of everything that I got using my pitot tube, all my measurements. First things first, we've got just an open pipe. So that smoke is blowing straight up and away. That's great. That's the preferred method. So next, let's try this B vent that I pulled off that other house. And you can see the smoke is blowing straight down. So we do not want to use this. This would not be allowed per the radon standards. And we're going to put the link in the description. So be sure to check that out. There's like 3 or 4 pages in the standard just dedicated to exhaust discharge. So if I miss something or I misspeak on it, be sure to check out the standard. And that changes periodically too. So the time you're watching this video, the standard may have changed a little bit. But the main reason we don't want this type of discharge is it blows the radon laden air down and to the side. And if we have a window next to this, you know, I can feel the breeze from that here. So we don't want to blow that radon laden air where it can get back into the house or, you know, say they had a deck or patio or something right here. You want it to get up and away from the house as quickly as possible. So with that open vent cap, we remove an 83 CFM with this RP145. With this, we're moving 82.2 CFM, so a little bit less. Now we'll go to a 45. We are moving 81.5 CFM. This would be allowed, and you can see it kind of blows it up at a 45. Next, let's try the T. So the T is also moving 81.5 CFM, so the same as the 45. And the T pushes it off to the side. This is allowed in certain instances, so make sure you check the standard to make sure that you're in compliance if you choose to go this method. Next, we have a 90. Our 90 is gonna blow everything to the side, as you can imagine. And it might be hard to pick up on camera, but kind of blowing everything this way. You can feel the breeze way out here. So this again is allowed in certain instances, but not preferred. And that 90 is moving 80 CFM, or the system's moving 80 CFM with that 90. Next, we'll try the critter guard from Ray Donaway or varmint guard with a half inch screen. And as you can imagine, that goes straight up, kind of a little tornado effect there. We used to use these on all of our systems until I talked to somebody that's smarter than I am, and they said that this is kind of where the ice starts. So we've gotten away from using these, except if we've got a tree above the house where we know we might get some acorns or branches or something falling in there. And then if the homeowner has like squirrel problems, we'll use something like this. And with that varmint guard with the half inch screen, we're moving 79 CFM, and that is allowed. Next, we've got this quarter inch screen, so the screen's closer together. So just like the rest, that kind of goes up in kind of a tornado spirally fashion. And with that one, we're moving 77.5 CFM. So we've got a little bit more restriction with that. And then our last one is gonna be this U-turn where it's blowing it straight down. Now this is not allowed. And I can feel that wind blowing all over the roof here. It's blowing it straight down to the roof. I hope that was helpful. It was kind of awkward to shoot, but hopefully Danielle can work her editing magic. If you have any other questions, comments, concerns, anything you'd like us to shoot a video on or maybe address, leave that in the comments below. We're looking for new content. If you found the video helpful, give it a thumbs up, maybe subscribe. And until then, we'll see you next time. I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thank you so much for watching.